Welcome to Logbook Checker and thank you for downloading the app. We're going to go through a few settings when you first start up the app that you'll need to enter before you start using the app. First question that comes up is, would you like to send notifications? These notifications are for alarms that are set for when you want to stop driving. So if you don't allow, you won't get those alarms. So click on allow to allow those alarms to be shown when they occur. Now you're confronted with three different options. The other two, the two bottom options, download diary from iCloud or restore diary from iCloud, that's for users that are transferring their information from another device. But we're gonna hit start a new diary for those people who are just using the app for the first time. Comes up with a help screen, which tells you how you can get help by just holding down your finger on any of the screens. Let's hit done and remove that. As you can see here, there's a number of settings that you might want and information you want to enter before you start using the app. First one is your name. So put in your first name and last name here. This is what's going to appear on the driver work diaries that the app draws up for you. So I've entered test driver. I'm going to enter a dummy license number and choose my license state. Get rid of the keyboard. The next question is, have you got a B of M? Now this setting here is where you put in, if you've got B of M and your company is accredited for B of M, you put in their B of M accreditation number in there. Having selected B of M does not mean that it will use B of M from then on. You choose your fatigue option when you add or edit a log sheet, and we'll show you that in another video. The next two options are about how the app counts. If you're driving using WA rules, these two settings won't make any difference whichever way you select them. However, if you're driving under NHVR rules, they will make a difference. Both options, you can choose any option there, turn the switches on or off, and it will still be legal. It's just how comfortable you feel about the way the app counts. The first is for old counting 24-hour period. What that does is, instead of counting from the end of every minor rest break, which if you turn it on, that's what it will do. It'll count from the end of every minor rest break. If you turn it off, it'll only count from the end of a major rest break, which in the case of solo is 7 hours or longer, or in the case of two up, 5 hours or longer, and that can be a non-stationary rest break. That's when it's counting work and rest time for a 24-hour period. And what this allows you to do, if you're up on your hours and you have this option turned off, you don't have to match the work periods and rest periods from the day previous, which is perfectly legal now for you to do that. It has been for some time. The second one is in regards to counting rest and work hours for a 7, 14 or 28 day period. So 7 in the case of standard hours, 14 in the case of BFM and standard hours, and 28 day period for the standard bus. If you have this turned on, it will only count from the end of any major rest break, which in the case of solo, ours will be a 7 hour rest break or longer. So when it's counting work rest time, it'll count from the end of any major rest break. Whereas if you have it turned off, it will only count from the end of a 24 hour break or longer when counting work rest time for a 14 day period. As we said, both options are actually legal, so you can choose either. It's just whether you would like to for it to count more aggressively, which old count, if you have them both turned off, that is what it will do. We recommend having the first option, 24-hour period turned off, and the second one turned on. But as the law enforcers get more up to date with the counting rules that are actually shown in the front of your driver work diary, then that turning it off will be no troubles at all. Once you've entered the information, your name, make sure your name is right, your license number is correct, just hit done, and that will save your user details.